Hi, I'm Chaplain David May with Good News Jail and Prison Ministry. What's new at the juvenile detention facility is the probation department has asked Good News to provide a chaplain to serve in their facility. They've had some chaplains before, volunteers before, but this is the first time they've asked our organization to provide chaplaincy services, and we are so excited at the opportunity. Chaplain Mandy Navarez has been with us part-time. She is going to be brought on full-time to serve the youth there. And we're real excited about this opportunity. And we appreciate the confidence the probation department has in us and in our organization.
Well, the ministry at Juvenile Hall has affected my life because 10 years ago, I went in first as a volunteer and when I was pregnant with my youngest daughter. And it was before the jail ministry, before becoming a chaplain, not knowing the direction that God would lead me in, and to really get a sense of the need that is in the facility. And now, 10 years later, having the opportunity to go in as a chaplain, I'm very excited to see what God's going to do in that area.
I like to go out and I like to pull our ladies out of the sex industry, out of the prostitution, and take them to safe places. I go out and I work with our drug addicts, our homeless, just anybody that really needs to be loved. I want to love them because it was the love that brought me through my addiction. I had tried several programs and nothing really seemed to work. But the second I was in custody and I got a little taste of what God's love was, I desired that more than I desired my bag of dope. And so it's the love.
The chaplain ministry had an impact in my life. His name was Chaplain DeBo. When I was in the youth authority, I really seen a peace on his life that it sort of frightened me, but I remember him always coming into the unit, and back at that time, we was able to smoke, and I remember always turning off my cigarette because I respected the man, you know, and I started to really find myself experiencing having a greater desire to want to read my Bible.
Is what I would say to people that support ministries for the juveniles is thank you. Because if we start with them young, then maybe we won't have them checking into the big boys' house. These times and these days, with everything that's going on now, we need to reach out and we need to support our ministries, not just our big boy ministries, but our little boy and little girl ministries too. So thank you.
Well, we are excited because we're going to begin July 1st. Some of you may be seeing this video this very day. So we're excited to begin this ministry. Thank you so much for all of you who support, who partner with us in this ministry. And God bless.